Yes, the cats definitely seem to be the new rulers, the new sultans of the city, especially during the weekends, since President Erdogan decided to impose every weekend a total lockdown, which means no one at all is allowed to go to the streets. Public transportations are not working. As you can see on these pictures, the restaurants, the cafes, everything is closed. You can just meet cats in the streets, sometimes dogs and seagulls, and that's about it. During the week, it's a different story. The government has bet on keeping, as President Erdogan says, keeping the wheels of the economy turning. So factories are still functioning, certain companies are still functioning. Instead, the government has relied more on wearing masks. It's mandatory. You have to wear a mask anytime you go to into a bus during the week, or you go to the supermarket. There are big restrictions also regarding social distancing, and there's an age restriction. If you're under 20 or above 65, you're not allowed at all to go out of
Wow.
your house. That's how it's going on these days in Istanbul. But it feels, yes, so strange for a city which never sleeps, which is always booming all the time. Whenever you put your feet out in the streets, it feels so. It's my vision of the end of the world. That's what I mentioned in my article.
And your article concludes with your worry, because you wrote the piece at the beginning of the week about what it would be like with the beginning of Ramadan. And it's here now. It's the first day of Ramadan. What's it like?
Yes, I mean it's really tough for the families. The month of Ramadan is a month of family gathering. Everybody visits their relatives, their loved ones in their houses every day at the end of the fast, to break the fast. So it's a total different flavor. It's really tough. It's challenging. So people who can afford it, of course, rely on as you in France rely on Zoom gatherings. But I think that is totally unprecedented as well in Turkey, as well as other Muslim countries. The mosques are totally closed. There's no mosque. So it's really, I mean, it's becoming the new normal, but it's so surreal.
Let me ask you about that, because we did a show on Thursday about Ramadan and COVID-19. And yeah, in Turkey, they're respecting the rules. In Iran, they're respecting the rules. In Saudi Arabia, they're respecting the rules. In Pakistan and Afghanistan, the mosques are open. Your thoughts on that, Delphine?
Yes, indeed. I mean, it's the case in some Muslim countries, but also in Catholic countries where the spread of the coronavirus was increased because of certain religious gatherings. I mean, you have clerics, you have priests, you have different leaders of different religious communities who, up to now, keep on insisting that coronavirus is made up in Israel or in the US, and you shouldn't follow what the TV is saying. It's so dangerous. I mean, thankfully, it's not the case in Turkey, where most of the people are trying to be responsible and trying to follow the rules, or at least to listen to what the doctors are saying.